measurement of time. We are discussing measurement of time. So we have discussed simple pendulum, and we have discussed the terms related with that. That is, oscillations we'll revise little bit. Okay, oscillations we have discussed. What do you mean by oscillation? If this is our rigid support, string is suspended, and then we have the metallic sphere made up of iron ore, brass. So heavy metallic this we have cylinder sphere, and this is called as bob. This is called as our bob. Okay, now oscillations means, okay, this is the mean position, this is the extreme positions, these are the extreme positions. Oscillations means, what do you mean by oscillation? What do you mean by oscillation? The time, oscillations means one complete to and fro motion. Okay, one complete to and fro motion is called as one oscillation. This is clear. What do you mean by oscillation? One complete to and fro motion, or one complete cycle. That is bob moving to one extreme position, from mean position to the extreme position, coming back to the mean position and going back to the other extreme position and coming back. So this one cycle, this is called as one oscillation. After this, we discussed time period. What do you mean by time period? Time taken by the bob to complete one oscillation. Time taken to complete one oscillation, we denoted it with T, and unit is second. After that, we discussed time period, we discussed frequency. That is number of oscillations made in 1 second. Number of oscillations made in 1 second, that we denote with F or N, or earlier classes you have used mu as well. How these are related? F equal is inversely related to time period, 1 upon T. So F equal to 1 upon T. Frequency is inversely related to time period. Okay. Then we discuss amplitude. Amplitude means the maximum displacement of the bob on either side. Maximum displacement. How much maximum it has moved away from the mean position. Okay. Then the effective length. For all the measurements, you have to take the effective length. Okay. Till it is not in question to be mentioned. From rigid support, distance. This is the length of the string, and this is radius of the bob. So we are taking the distance from this one, rigid support, where it has been hanged, this point of suspension to the center of mass of the bob. This total distance will be how much? Length of the string plus radius of the bob. This is our effective length. Understood? These all we have discussed. Then we discussed measurement of time. Okay. So how many haven't understood measurement of time? The table, go through the table once. Go through the table once. Measurement of time. We did. So in this case, what we did? We took the pendulum of particular length, for example, 25 centimeter. Okay, when it is of 25 centimeter length, and it starts to oscillate. So length we have taken, then time taken to complete 20 oscillations, then time taken to complete one oscillation. Okay, and after that we calculated L upon T ratio. Okay, so when the length is 25, so first we have taken this pendulum's length as 25. Okay, it means the effective length only 25 centimeters. Okay, now when it, how in how much time it has, it is oscillate, making oscillations, how many? 20 oscillation. So 22 and fro motions, 22 and fro motions. Okay, so we measure time taken to complete 20 oscillations. And for example, it came out to be 20 seconds. This time is in second, this is in second, this is in centimeter. So when the length is 25 centimeter, and to complete 20 oscillation, time taken is 20 seconds. So to complete one oscillation, how many seconds? 20 divided by 20?
1 second.
20 oscillation, 1 second. Okay. leave it here. Don't calculate. Okay, next we have increased the length. For example, 36 centimeters we took this time length. Now again we measured the time taken to complete 20 oscillations, and it came out to be 24, for example. Okay, so one oscillation will be how much time taken to complete one oscillation? 1.2 seconds. This is the time period we are calculating. That is the time to complete one oscillation or taken for one oscillation. Similarly, for different lengths we did. Okay. And lastly, for 100 centimeters, that is for 1 meter. This time, the time taken for oscillations is how much? 20 oscillations. 40 seconds. You can see here one thing as well. Length is increasing. Pendulum is taking more time to complete 20 oscillations. Or, so it will be how much? 2 seconds. Time period is 2 seconds.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So some observations we can make. See here, as length is increasing, time period is increasing or decreasing?
Increasing.
Time period is increasing. So they are directly related. They are directly proportional, and how they are related, that we'll be seeing here. Okay. As length is increasing, time period is increasing. Okay. Time period is increasing. Okay. So is the clock going fast or slow? If time period is increasing, it will be slow. Okay. That we'll be discussing more in detail after some time as well. Okay. Now take L upon T ratio. L upon T ratio. So how much it will be? 25 upon 1 square. 25. Similar take here. 36 upon 1.2 square. How much it is coming?
25.
Okay, take it here. 100 divided by 4. 25. So what you observed here, L upon T square is constant. This L upon T square is constant. Or we can say, if you are varying the length, right? If you are varying the length, time period as well varies. That is proportional, some relation is there. So time period is proportional to length of the pendulum. Time period is proportional to that length of the pendulum. And how they are related? Root of L. You can see L upon T square is constant. So we can say T square is proportional to length of pendulum. T square is proportional to length of pendulum, or taking root on both sides, T is proportional to root of L. This we have derived by these observations. That is time period, how it is related with length of the pendulum. Time period is inversely proportional to root of L, square root of L. This is clear? This observation we have made. Okay. Okay. Now, if we make a graph. Okay, here I make the graph. Okay. So we have observed that L upon T square is constant. That is, it is coming out to be 25. So we can write L upon T square. It is constant. And how? What is the value of constant here? In this case, it is 25. Okay. So as we are varying L, time period varies. So L will be on the x-axis, corresponding to time period varies, and T square will be taking on y-axis. Okay. Independent variable on x-axis and dependent variable on y-axis. Mainly we follow this rule. Okay. Now plot these values. When length is 25, time period is 1. So 25, 1. When length is 36, time period is 1.2. Plot these values. Okay. And it comes out to be a straight line. Okay. Because L upon T square is constant. What is L upon T square? It's the slope. It's the slope of this line. And it is constant. Constant means it's a straight line. It's a straight line. We'll get this kind of curve. We are getting a straight line. This is clear. Now, how to calculate slope of this one, this line? Take any two points, P, Q. P, Q they have taken. Okay, P upper side. Okay, P, Q. Corresponding to P, project it on X axis perpendicularly. And we have here L1. Corresponding to L1, what is the time period? T1. Here it is in T square, T square. Corresponding to this point, we have L2. And here we have T2 square. Okay. So slope will be how much? This one, this is slope you have to calculate. Okay, you have already studied how to calculate slope in triangle. For example, this is a triangle. A, B, C. This slope you have to calculate. So slope will be BC upon AB length, perpendicular upon AB. This will give us the slope. And here, which triangle it is? This triangle. Mark it as A. Or R. R they have marked. We will as well mark R. Okay. R. This we have to calculate slope. So how slope will be what? P R divided by Q R. Understood this one? What is P R? What is P R? This length T1 square minus T2 square. This length is T1 square minus T2 square. Understood? What is Q R length? This one L1 minus L2. Or we can write T square divided by L. So slope of this curve will be T square upon L. Understood this one? How to calculate the slope? In mathematics as well, this chapter is there. We will study there as well in detail. This is clear? Anyone having doubt in calculating the slope? Okay. And see here, its value, this slope's value comes out to be 4 pi square upon g. That is, T square upon L, its value comes out to be 4 pi square upon g. Okay. Pi, 4 pi square upon g. So here only the variable is g. So depending on the change, that is, this constant, this slope will vary depending on gravitational acceleration. Acceleration due to gravity. So for different places, we have different acceleration due to gravity. Accordingly, this term will vary. That is, this slope will vary. Okay. Depending on acceleration due to gravity. Okay. And remaining, you can interchange and calculate like g equal to 4 pi square upon t square upon L. That is slope of t square versus L graph. Okay. This thing is clear. So this you have to remember. Okay. Or in other form, you will be remembering this. Okay. No need of remembering this one. In other form, we'll remember this one. Okay. Okay. We do it here only. Okay. So what we have got? T square upon L equal to 4 pi square upon G. L I take on this side. It can be written as T square 4 pi square L by G. It can be written in this form. Take the root on both sides. T equal to root of 4 pi square L by G. T equal to take the root 4 to pi square pi root of L by G. This formula you have to remember. Okay. This formula, it will be used mainly in this chapter. So what you have to remember, time period equal to 2 pi root of L by G. Understood this one? So time period depends on length of the pendulum. We have seen. As it varies the length, time period varies. So time period depends on length of the pendulum. Time periods depend on acceleration due to gravity. Only on these two terms it depends. Time period depends only on two terms, which are length of the pendulum and acceleration due to gravity. If any of these varies, time period will vary. Okay. Next is we'll be discussing factors on which affects the time period of pendulum. factors affecting the time period. As well, we'll be discussing the factors which do not have any effect on time period.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Why double yes? Okay, next one. Factors affecting the time period of a simple pendulum. First one is length. How it is varying with length? T is proportional to root of L. T is proportional to root of L. So if length increases, time period increases. So how? So see here, in winter, what is going to happen? What will happen to length of the pendulum?
It will decrease.
It will decrease. Why? It contracts, bob contracts as well as the string contracts. Bob contracts as well as the string contract. So length decreases. As length becomes smaller, what will happen to the time period?
It will increase.
It will increase.
Again, see, length is decreasing. Time period will
decrease.
It will decrease. It will decrease. You can see from this proportionality, from this equation as well, length decreases, time period decreases. Okay, what does it mean decrease in time period? Okay, I give you one example here. Okay. For example, you are drinking coffee. Okay. You are drinking coffee and you take 5 minutes to drink the coffee. Okay. You are having clock in your home, that is pendulum clock you are having. Okay. And you take 5 minutes to drink the coffee when we are taking some length. Okay. Now see here, for example, you are somewhere in between September or October. Okay. September, October, that times we have the very temperature is not much higher or much lower. Okay. So pendulum length is okay. We are taking some pendulum length. You took 5 minutes. Now weather changed and now it comes winter. Okay. You always take 5 minutes, not a second more, not a second less. Always remember this one. You are drinking a coffee and you always take 5 minutes only. Not a second more, not a second less. Okay. Now winter comes. As winter comes, length of pendulum decreases. Time period decreases. That is, length of the pendulum decreases, time period decreases means the pendulum is moving more fast. Yes or no? That is, clock becomes faster. Time period decreases when time period decreases means it completes one oscillation in less time. It completes one oscillation in less time. It means it is moving a little bit more faster. It will move a little bit more faster. Okay. So what will happen to your drinking coffee? Will you be able to complete? Now the clock has become faster. So clock has become faster. Now 1 hour will be completed very early. What time it should take? 1 hour. Earlier it was taking, now it will take less time to complete 1 hour. It will show on the clock that is 1 hour is completed. So what will happen to your coffee drinking? In how many minutes you will complete? More than 5 or less than 5?
More than 5.
More than 5.
You are going to take more than 5 minutes. The clock will show that more than 5 minutes have passed. But you are taking the same time to complete the to drink the coffee. But the what clock is going to show that you are taking now in winter, you are taking more time to drink coffee. But in reality, what has happened? Clock has gone faster. But in reality, clock has gone faster. This is clear. So winter length decreases, time period decreases, and clock become faster. That is, 1 hour will be completed very early. The clock will show that 1 hour is completed very early. Okay. Now, again, March, April, and now you are drinking in June. Okay. And it's 1st or 3rd June. Even rainfall is not taking place. So high temperature is there, or my hand you can take. High temperature, what happens to the bob length? What happens to the pendulum's length? So in summer, pendulum length increases. As it increases, Time period?
Increases.
Time period as well increases. Time period increases means it is taking more time to complete the one oscillation. Time period increases, that means clock has become?
Slow.
Slower it has become? It has gone slow. And this time, how many minutes the clock will show? You are taking
less,
to complete.
Less than five.
Less it will show, that means clock will show that you have drank your coffee in 4 minutes or 4.56 minutes. That is 4 minutes and 56 seconds. Okay. Clock has gone slower. Now it is taking more time. That is what 1 hour is exactly what it is. It is taking more time and it is showing that hour is very long. That hour is very long. Clock is showing that one. Understood this one? So in winter, clock goes faster. In summer, clock goes slow. Understood everyone? Okay, this thing you try to interpret yourself at home. Okay, think over it and you will get the answer. Okay, if you don't get it, ask tomorrow. This thing is clear? So,
yes, sir.
1 minute, stay in class. We are staying. Okay, time is here. So, this how with length, how the time period varies. Time period is inverse, is directly related to square root of L. Okay, this how the time period varies. Okay, okay. One example as well is given, that is while you are standing on the swing, your center of mass rises up. Less effective length means more faster you will move. Okay. Second, how it varies with G, with gravity. 1 upon root G. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Time period is inversely related with square root of acceleration due to gravity. Okay. If gravity decreases,
Time period increases.
Okay. Second thing is gravity increases.
Time period decreases.
Decreases. Okay. Time period increases. That means clock has gone slower or faster?
Slower.
Okay. Time period has decreased. It means clock has gone slower or faster?
Faster.
Okay. Now we have to see how gravity varies. Okay. If this is the surface of the earth. Okay. If you are going underground, that is in mines you are going, how gravity increases or decreases?
Decreases.
If you are going, gravity decreases. See here, maximum gravity is on the surface. If you move down inside the earth surface, inside the earth, it decreases. As well, you move up in the sky, it will decrease.
It will decrease.
Gravity decreases. So see here, whether you maximum gravitational force, maximum gravity on the surface of the earth. Okay, as you go down, it decreases. As you move up, it decreases. So maximum at the surface. Usually in high classes, you study the graph. Okay, this will be the graph. Here is the G and this is the distance. That is, this is the radius of the earth. That is the surface of the earth. Okay, so as we are moving deep in, this is the center of the earth. As you are moving inside the earth, you can see gravity is decreasing. As you are moving on the mountain, that is up more over the surface of the earth, up in the air, gravity is decreasing. So maximum gravity is on the surface. So if you are going in mines, the clock is going to be slow. If you are going up in the mountains, clock is going to be slow because gravity is decreasing. This is clear? Okay. Now, next term, Bob's mass. Does time period depend on? Yes.
Sir, what is compound pendulum?
Okay, we'll be discussing that one as well, compound pendulum. See here, what we have used? A simple string we have used. Yes or no? Just a single string. String we have used in compound pendulum, it's a matter. Mainly at home, we have compound pendulum, not the simple pendulum. How is the compound pendulum you have seen? This kind of shapes are there. Different kinds of shapes are there. Or simply it will be like this. A rod we take. Okay. A metallic strip is there. This is complete one metallic strip. It has the mass all around. Now it oscillates. So when we have metallic strip or any more designs are there, these are called as compound pendulums.
Okay, sir.
So here, see here. In simple pendulum, we have the concentrated mass in the bob. Here we have extended mass. Mass is extended over the whole surface or the whole body of the pendulum. Okay. You have seen these kind of pendulums mainly. Okay. In shops as well, you have seen the complete pendulum. Mainly these compound pendulums are used at home. Okay. And they oscillate around the horizontal axis. Around this horizontal axis, they oscillate. For example, this can act as a compound pendulum. Okay. It will oscillate like this. You have seen these only in shops and at home. So compound pendulums are mainly used. Okay. That is clear. Now, third one. How it varies with mass. Time period, how it varies with mass of the bob. Does it vary? Or how, if it varies, how it varies?
It's not varying.
Okay. We can as well get from the equation. Is there any mass term here? No mass term?
Yes, sir. No mass.
It means whatever the mass of the bob is, whatever mass of the bob we take, it doesn't matter. Time period remains same. Mass of the bob have no effect on time period. Mass of the bob have no effect on time period. Okay. Next one is amplitude. So how far it is moving from the mean position? Does it have effect on time period? Amplitude. Can you see any term of amplitude here?
No, sir.
No term. That means time period is independent of, it is independent of mass of bob as well as it is independent of amplitude of oscillation. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, expression we have already discussed for the time period. That is 2 pi root of L by G, where L is the effective length, G is the acceleration due to gravity. Always remember the units when you solve the questions. Length must be in meter. Gravitational force will be in how, what will be the, this is not gravitational force, it's acceleration due to gravity. Meter per second. Okay, do you know what do you mean by acceleration? Acceleration. Okay, we'll be doing in second day exercise. See, you already know speed.
Yes, sir.
Okay, if there is no change in speed, that is uniform speed, acceleration will be zero. Now speed varies. And how it varies, that is denoted by acceleration. How the speed varies. Okay. So for example, you are on a building, you throw a stone downward. So each second, each time its speed will be increasing. So for example, acceleration is 9.8 meter per second square. Or we can, okay, per second square. Or we can write it as 9.8 meter per second per second. It means each second the speed is changing from 9.8. If you are throwing downward, per second it is zero. 0 second, zero. After 1 second, speed will be 9.8. After next second, its speed will be 9.8 into 2. Okay. 19.6. It will be 19. So each second speed is increasing by 9.8. Or if you are throwing a stone upward, each second speed will be decreasing by 9.8. Okay. These all will be discussing next chapter. Okay. Second day chapter will be discussing. Okay. In detail, we will discuss. So don't be panic regarding them. Okay. Acceleration, this is clear time period. Okay, there is one more pendulum, there is second pendulum, second pendulum. A particular pendulum, second pendulum. In home, mainly we use this kind of pendulum. So second pendulum, here, what you have to remember, time period of the second pendulum is how much?
2 seconds.
2 seconds. Time period is 2 seconds. It means in 1 minute, how many oscillations it is making? If his time period is 2 seconds, in 1 minute, 30. How many 30 oscillations? His time period is 2 seconds. That is, it is taking 2 seconds to complete one complete oscillation. Okay, now I ask one question. If this is the position of the pendulum, simple pendulum, from here to here, how much time it will take? Seconds pendulum. One extreme position to the other extreme. 1 second. And coming back, total it will be 2 seconds. Total 2 seconds. Or this is the pendulum, moving this side, going back, coming back. How many seconds? Seconds pendulum. Again, see, moving on extreme position from mean position. Coming back to the mean position, going to the other extreme position, coming back. How many seconds?
2 seconds.
Two seconds. This is clear?
Yes. Sir.
Okay. So any doubt yes, you sir. Have in the chapter?
No, sir.
Okay. So what you have to do? Solve the numericals. Okay. Two things I have to tell. First thing, solve the numericals of first day. And we'll be discussing these in next lecture. All the numericals we'll be discussing in next lecture. Okay, along with what you have to do first A exercise. If you have solved the numericals, it's good. If you haven't, solve them in your notebook. First exercise, page number 10. Solve those numericals in your notebook. Write proper steps. What is being given that you have to write first, then start the solution. Okay, so those numericals as well you have to do. Okay, and more. And other than that, you have to do page number 9, open page number 9. Question answers are given, okay? You don't have to write the question answers in notebook, okay? Remember, you don't have to write the question answers. You have to just write numericals, okay? And numericals as well, you don't have to write the question, just solution. And, okay, one is leaving, he will remove, okay? So, in exercise first day, first 10 questions. In exercise first day, first 10 questions. Prepare them, find out the answers, prepare answers. If you don't get the answers, either ask in class or the answer requires you to frame the answer. Try to frame the answer in your own words, okay? So mainly you can frame the answers in your own words. That is fine. Prepare these 10 questions. No need of writing notebook. And I'll be asking Monday onwards to some students these 10 questions. From these 10 questions, I'll be randomly ask 2 or 3 students, okay? Every day, 2 or 3 minutes, I will give for that. Okay. And then after that, next 10 we will prepare. So on Monday onwards, we start this practice. Okay. This is clear.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then we end the class here. Any doubt here, you can stay here and ask.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you all.
Thanks, sir.